As a talented artist, he got the chance to create the chief.
He was like one of the biggest heroes that Cleveland area had created.
Chief Wahoo was a fixture at Municipal Stadium for decades until 1994, when the tribe moved to then Jacobs Field.
If you're wondering what happened to the Chief Wahoo that used to sit on top of the old Cleveland Municipal Stadium, well, it's right here at the Cleveland History Center. It is, after all, a key part of Cleveland history.
Goldbach remembers Wahoo being a big hit even when the Indians were struggling.
Chief Wahoo, you look at him, and all he wants to tell you is, come on, let's win a few games. I got a smile on my face. And that's the way I feel.
We are people!
He never imagined it would become offensive to anybody, but it did. Eventually, Native Americans rose up in protest. They organized demonstration outside Progressive Field.
Not your mascots!
And while some fans pushed to keep the chief, others admitted it was time for a change.
I think it's a tribute. I don't think it's anything derogatory. I think it's a tribute to the fighting spirit and to the history of the Indians.
I think this is just another big step in the right direction. And we do, as a community, appreciate it, not just here in Cleveland, but across the country.
While the protests made headlines, Major League Baseball was working with the Indians behind the scenes. And today, Commissioner Rob Manfred announced that after the 2018 season, the Indians' association with the chief will cease. The logo is no longer appropriate for on-field use in Major League Baseball, and I appreciate Mr. Dolan's acknowledgement that removing it from the on-field uniform by the start of the 2019 season is the right course. Indians CEO Paul Dolan says this is the hardest decision he's had to make. While we recognize many of our fans have a long-standing attachment to Chief Wahoo, I'm ultimately in agreement with Commissioner Manfred's desire to remove the logo from our uniforms in 2019. Lou Maglio, Fox 8 News.